Stephen. I'm the director of ministries here at Solid Rock Apostolic Church. We have a lot of things going on this week, and we really want to have you involved. Here's what we got going on. Okay, after this amazing service that we're about to have, there's a little thing going on called the Super Bowl. So, rock solid men, we're going to meet here at the church at 5:30. We're going to have a projector set up. We're going to watch the Super Bowl. Bring an appetizer, a snack, a drink, something. We're all just going to pitch in and have a good time. Ladies, you're going to be meeting at Sister Lugina's house at 5 o'clock, and you guys are going to have a wonderful time. We hope to see you there. Come out. It's going to be a great time. All right, youth, this Friday, you guys are going to be crashing the Richardsons. That's right. You're going to meet here at the church at 7 o'clock. Travel over to Brother Alex and Sister Angie's house and just decimate it. Just completely destroy it. Or just hang out. One or the other. I'm not really sure which. But either way, it's going to be a great time. You guys are also going to be back by 11. So make sure you let your parents know. And please come out and join the youth. Okay, college and career. You guys are going to have a fiesta.
Olé.
All right. You guys are going to be meeting here at the church at 7 o'clock. And you are going to be on this wonderful show called Cooking with Ty. I've seen it on Facebook a few times. He's going to show you guys how to cook his world-famous tamales. And then you guys are assumedly going to eat them, which means I may show up. I'm not sure. Either way, it's going to be a wonderful time. Come on out and join. Okay, Saturday, February the 10th at 6 p.m. here at the church, we're going to have our first daddy-daughter banquet. This is going to be a fun, wonderful time, dads, for you to bring your daughters and show them how they should be treated like a lady that they are. Okay, so it's $25 for you and your daughter to attend, and then $10 for each additional person to attend with your group. The tickets are being sold out in the foyer, so just go out there, pick them up, and we really hope to see you there. This is going to be a wonderful thing, investing in our daughters' lives. Okay, so those are all of our announcements. So now I've got something for you to do. If this is your first time joining us, we would love for you to fill out a Connect card. It's pretty simple. It's got a couple of things to fill out if you want to. You've got your name, email address, phone number. We'd love to be able to reach out to you and tell you about the wonderful things we have going on. And if you want to get to know more about us, it's real easy. You can download our app from the app stores by searching SRAC. You can also visit us on the web at gosrac.com. All right, that's it. We are about to have an amazing service, and we are so glad you're here with us.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Let's all stand. It is great to be in the house of God today. I've came here for one purpose only, to lift up His name. Can we lift our hands and lift up His name right now? We thank You, Jesus. Lord, we thank You, Lord, and we praise You, God. Lord, we ask You to have Your way in this service today, God. Lord, Jesus, fill hearts, God. Fill someone with the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, we thank You. We never want to fail to give You the honor and the praise. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's give Him a hand clap of praise. Worship with them as they sing.
Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's keep that hand clap of praise going. Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus. How many know that our God is greater? Hallelujah. We thank You, Jesus. Oh, we love You, Lord. And water You turned into wine. You opened the eyes of the blind. There's no one like You. There's none like You. And into the darkness You shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like You. There's none like You. Yes, our God. And our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, You are higher than any other. Our God is healer. He's awesome in power. Our God. Oh, our God. Yes, you shine out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. Yes, there's no one like our God. Oh, yes, our God is greater. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are high. Stronger, God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer. He's awesome in power. Our God, oh, our God.
Hallelujah, all of this house, just lift up a shout of praise right now. Oh yeah.
Then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against?
Oh yes, what could stand against? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, Jesus. Let's keep our hands clapping right now all over this house. He deserves all the glory. He deserves all the praise. We worship and we thank you, oh God. Thank you, Jesus.
There was between us. By the cross you came and broke them down.
My name, and then my heart came alive. Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me.
Oh yes, your love awakens me.
Call me into the light. You called my name and then my heart came alive.
place. For the announcements and all.
Praise the Lord. You can be seated this morning. Amen. Several announcements this morning. The laundry detergent fundraiser. Today is the last day for that. If you can turn in your money, give that to Sister Allison O'Shell. And the delivery for that is going to be on Sunday, February 25th. Also, to the moon and back, it's our first annual father-daughter banquet. It's going to be this coming up Saturday, February the 10th, starting at 6 p.m. here at Solid Rock. $25. You can see Sister Crystal Gifford after service today, and she will get your tickets for that event. And also coming up on Saturday, April the 7th, is our quarter auction fundraiser. That is going to support our Solid Rock and Boom. And if you can see Sister Gina Miller, she needs help with donations, and she greatly appreciates your help. At this time, we'll have our ushers come and take up our Sunday morning tithe and offering. We'll have Brother Mike O'Shell say the prayer this morning.
For criminals and every Pharisee, you came for hypocrites, even one like me. You carried sin and shame, the guilt of every man, the weight of all I've done, and nailed into your hand. And oh, your love bled for me. Oh, your blood in crimson streams. Oh, your death is hell's defeat. Across your amazing grace, I've seen and tasted it. It's running through my veins, I can't escape its grip. In you my soul is safe, you cover everything. Oh, your love, yes, your love bled for me. Oh, a cross meant to kill is my victory.
Hallelujah. Oh, why don't we just love the Lord all over this house and thank Him for the victory that He's given to us. Hallelujah.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away our sins, who takes away our sins. Makes us alive again, makes us alive again. The whole, the Lamb of God, who takes away our sin, who takes away our sin.
Yes, the Holy Lamb,
the Holy Lamb of God, makes us alive again, makes us alive.
Oh, your love.
cross meant to kill is my victory. Hallelujah, yes, it's my victory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All over this house, just lift your hands and love the Lord right now. Hallelujah, we magnify your name, we magnify your name. Oh. And our Father, Creator, you hold our hearts together. There's no one higher than you. Redeemer, Defender, our great and mighty Savior. There's no one higher than you. And you are always with us, gracious to forgive us. And by your power we've been set free. And Lord, we stand amazed in your presence, astounded by your mercy and love. And our hands are lifted high in surrender. And your grace for me is always enough. And there is no one higher than our God. And there is no one greater than you. Let my life forever praise the glory of your name. For there is no one higher than you. Majestic in wonder, your living love forever. There's no one higher than you. Oh, your beauty, your beauty, your splendor, your glory knows no measure. There's no one higher than you, for you are, and you are always with us, gracious to forgive us. By your power we've been set free, and Lord we stand, and Lord we stand amazed in your presence. We're astounded, astounded by your mercy and love. And our hands are lifted high in surrender. And your grace for me is always enough. And there is no one higher than our God. And there is no one greater than you. Let my life, for there is no one higher than you. and our hands are lifted high in surrender. And your grace for me is always enough. And there is no one higher than our God. And there is no one greater than you. Let my life forever praise the glory of your name. There is no one higher than you, and there is no one higher than you.
Hallelujah. All of in this house, just love the Lord with everything you have in you. Lift up a shout of praise right now. Hallelujah.
If you believe that today, want to lift up holy hands as high as you can. Lift up your head and just believe it. Declare it. There's no one greater than your God. There's no one greater than your God. The God that you're serving right now, there's no one greater, no one higher. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Yeah, that's it. That's it. From a thankful heart, just worship. Hallelujah. He's a great God. Worthy of great praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hallelujah.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. It's easy to praise God because He's done so much for me. Amen, amen. I know Him as a friend. I know Him as a forgiver. I know Him as a merciful God. I know Him as a faithful God. It's easy to worship God. It's easy to worship Him today. One more time, let's worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord together. Come on, a very personal way. You know what I'm talking about. That God that forgave you, that God that was with you in the hardest time of your life, He was there. Oh, God, His fingerprints are everywhere to your situation. It's attached. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's it, that's it. The evidence is overwhelming. His fingerprints are everywhere. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, just for a minute right now. Look back at your trial and see the fingerprints everywhere on the ground. Come on, God was there. God was there. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The evidence is overwhelming. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God, praise God, praise God. Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Don't you love the Lord? Man, let's give Him a hand clap of praise today. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. If you have your Bibles today, if you grab your Bibles, your iPads, your phones, however you read God's Word today, get a hold of it. Turn with me to the book of Psalms, chapter number 34. As you're turning to the book of Psalms, chapter 34, I want to say how good it is to see Brother Tyler and Sister Amanda in the house of the Lord with us today. Like, I'm going to let that one slide by. I love them very much so, and glad that they're with us, and glad we've got some return visitors back here with Sister Natalie. So could you give them a hand as well? Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming back. Thank you for coming back. And we're thankful for that today. And if I missed you today, I apologize. God is just so good to us today. His mercy endureth forever, forever. Praise God. Praise God. Psalms chapter 34. One more announcement. I didn't get a chance, but this coming Sunday, if you'd like to
like to play a little basketball with us. We'll be having basketball this coming Sunday, and every other Sunday we're going to play a little volleyball. And I think it's good just to fellowship together and just have a good time together. And I also think it's good, the exercise is good as well. Praise God. Amen. Time to get this temple in order. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Verse 18 of Psalms 34, it reads, "The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit." He's not close. He's close to those that have a broken heart. My God, hallelujah. He's close. Praise God. Whenever you feel broken on the inside, you do yourself justice to say, "He's close. He's close." In Psalms chapter 51 and verse number 17, it reads, "The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. Oh God, thou wilt not despise." Today, I know that I'm not going to preach to everyone on this, but maybe so. I don't know. I asked God even last night. I had another message prepared. In fact, let me give you the title of my other message. It's entitled, "Talking to Yourself." I had it all prepared, and the Lord stopped what I wanted to do and said, "You're going to do what I want you to do." And therefore, today, I've got to believe that God has a purpose. He's got a reason today, and I know that God's going to do something here today. Number one is I'm confident of that. Number one, because the Lord, I'm going to preach what the Lord told me to preach. I'm going to preach it the way God wanted me to preach it. I prayed over it, studied to show myself approved. And last but not least, right before I got up here, Clayton said, "Dad, come here." He says, "You got this." That's all I need. All I need. Amen. I want to inject something before I get rolling here, just to give you my heartbeat just for a little bit. Ever since January the 1st, something has changed in our church. I don't know if you can feel it like I can feel it. God is doing something. Something is happening in the spirit. And I will tell you that there are sometimes the anointing is so strong in this place, it's hard just to stand sometimes. It's very thick. And I think God has a purpose for that. I think God has a purpose for that. And I know God has a purpose for that. Today, I just want to encourage you, just dive all the way in. There's a point where you let go of the boat to walk on the water. You let go of the boat and walk on the water. And today, I want to encourage you that God's doing something. Here, if not this Wednesday, maybe next Wednesday, we're going to have a testimony service. There's some miracles that's been taking place in people's lives. You just don't know about it yet. But God's performing some pretty awesome things around us. So God's restoring some homes and some hearts. And today, I just believe that it's a great time to be serving the Lord. It's a perfect time to be serving the Lord today. We need the Lord's help in this service. I believe He's already here, don't you? Let's all pray. Jesus, Lord, I love You. I thank You, Lord. I appreciate You for Your Holy Spirit. God, You are such a good and faithful God. We just serve You. We love You, Jesus, God. We just want more of You, Lord. We ask You today, God, that Your Holy Ghost, Your Holy Spirit, God, would pour into these broken temples, God. God, we ask that the Holy Ghost, God, would pour into us, Lord. God, we want to capture this season. We want to capture this time, God, that You've got us into, Lord. God, we understand, God, that we're in the living in the last days, God. And we don't have that much more time, but Lord, we want to be ready. We want to be ready, God, to meet You, Lord. Help us, oh God. Help Your children, we pray to You. Heavenly Father, we love You and praise You. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And everyone said, in Jesus' name. You may be seated today if you promise not to sit down on me. There is an established principle that I feel we must find ourselves in front of today. I don't know why, right in the middle of a breakthrough, God has laid this message on my heart, and God has moved us into a place where I think that His will and desire is so strong. Last week, last Sunday, I want to bring back to your remembrance, the Holy Ghost was so strong that God was still dealing with hearts even an hour after church was over. Many people that went home, God was already dealing with them, and God was revealing His power, His sovereignty in our lives, how every step that we've been taken was ordered of by the Lord. It is my desire today to preach about a revelatory word from the Lord that why we experience breakthrough, brokenness must be a part of the process. Brokenness can bring us to a new dimension in God through which no other doors may lead. And sometimes I wish that God would use a different door, but brokenness is always a part of that journey of a breakthrough. There are places God wants to bring us to, and I believe as a church that God wants to bring our church to a different level of expectation, a different level of revival and victorious living in God, a different level where our worship and our praise is inhibited, and our zealousness of God, that zeal that we have to require more of Him is not chained up or not bound up, but there is a loosing of God's Spirit that can only come on the outside of brokenness. It can only come through times that you've been through a storm and times that you've been through some hard times that God takes us to these moments. There are places God wants to bring us, but the price of admission is brokenness. We can't get to these places through faith, through victory, through shouting, through praise, but just brokenness today is what I want to deal with. Although not a bone of our Lord was broken, when the Lord was crucified and bore our sins in His body, the Bible describes His body as being broken. Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 24, it says, "And when He had given thanks, He brake it and said, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me." Our Lord was broken, but through His brokenness, salvation was made available for you and for me. But salvation cannot be known without repentance, and a place in brokenness is necessary for repentance. The Bible says godly sorrow worketh repentance. The Bible says that we must be broken before we can be fixed. Maybe we could turn the saying around a little bit today. If it ain't broke, then God can't fix it. That's why I think that our prayers should be this: Lord, God, break me where you need to break me, God, and make me, Lord, the way you want to make me, Jesus. Because if it ain't broke, then God can't fix it. Many times we curse brokenness, but let me tell you, God has always used brokenness to get us to our breakthrough. God has always used a downtime so that He can establish a high time in the Lord. God has always used a symbolism of total surrender so that His great work and His will can be established in our lives. God uses brokenness. God uses brokenness. He uses those midnight prayers when the heavy spirit of weeping has come upon you. God uses those moments when you feel frustrated on the inside so that your faith can be elevated on the inside. God uses a broken and a contrite spirit because He chases after those. He chases after those that have it. God uses a breaking point so that He can establish His will and His dominion for your life. God uses these breaking points in our life, and when things seem out of control, God says, "Now I can be in control." God sometimes has got to take you to a place where you lose it so you can find Him. He sometimes takes you to a place where you don't know what to do so that He can be your all in all, so that He can be your great I am. Sometimes God gets you in a place where you're boxed in so tight that you look to your right, you can't move. You look to your left, you can't move. Front and behind, you feel like your doors are closing in. God takes you there because He wants you to be the, He wants you to know that He's the only one that can part the Red Sea. He's the only one that can make a door out of no way. He's the only one that can give you
an exit strategy for a dominion, a demonic approach on your life. God is the only help. He's the only way of salvation. He's the only door that can be opened. God just doesn't want to be your fit. He wants to be your all in all. He wants to be your friend. He wants to be your salvation. He wants to be your miracle worker. God just doesn't want to be your help. He wants to be your help in time of trouble. That's what God uses. He uses brokenness to usher in a breakthrough so that God can get the glory. James chapter 4 and verse 6, it says, but he giveth more grace. Wherefore he saith, God resisteth the proud. He resisteth the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil, and he will, someone say will, he will flee from you. Draw nigh unto God, and he will draw nigh unto you. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, ye double-minded. Be afflicted and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned into mourning and your joy to heaviness. Humble yourselves. Humble yourselves on the side of the Lord, and he shall lift you up. God can only lift you up if you will go down and worship. This is opposite of our thinking in our today's culture. Because we understand that we think that we got to be high in order for the Lord to take us higher. And that is not true. The Bible says you got to go down before you can be lifted up. You say, that's not making sense, Pastor. I want to go higher and higher. I don't want to go lower. And yet God is telling someone here today, trust me here, someone, he's telling someone to stop trying to lean on their own understanding and quit leaning on your own ability. God will take you to another dimension, but you won't be able to get there by yourself. You're not going to get there through your pride. God wants to get there through a worship. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. But to be a worshiper, even the concepts of worship, means that you've got to go down. You've got to worship in a prostrate position and say, Lord, I'm not equal to you. I'm not even on your dimension. God, I'm going down so that you can go up. I want to go down. The first shall be last and the last shall be first. God wants to move you to higher places, but he's got to get you out of the way.
Hallelujah.
God wants to do greater things in our church, but he's got to get me out of the way. God wants to do great things in your family, but he's got to get us out of the way. God wants to do great things in your ministry, but you got to get yourself out of the way. Crucify your flesh. Always lay your flesh on the altar. Always be willing to walk the mountain and say, God, I want to be broken before you today. Lord, I want to be broken. I want to be a worshiper. I want you, God, to move in me. God says, I'll give you a breakthrough, but it's only on the other side of brokenness. If you'll humble yourself, then I will be your God and lift it up. Sometimes it will be harder to break yourself than it will be to make yourself. Because breaking yourself means that you start over again. But God can do more out of a redo than what you can out of a next day experience. Humble yourselves before the Lord and God will exalt you. Before Abraham became the father of many nations, he and Sarah were childless. Before Jacob could be blessed, he was wounded by an angel in a wrestling match. Before Joseph ruled Egypt, he was thrown into a pit, sold into slavery, and falsely imprisoned. Before Job's estate was doubled, he lost everything he had, including his family, his fortune, and his future. Before Moses became the great deliverer, he lost his position, he lost his possessions, and he lost his popularity. Before Joshua conquered the promised land, he went through the wilderness. Before Samson crushed the Philistines, are you hearing me? He was blinded, binded, and grinded at the mill. Before David became king, he was renounced by his family, ridiculed by his foes, and rejected by his friends. Before Daniel can be used mightily, he had to spend a night in the lion's den. Before Hosea became a powerful spokesman of God, his wife betrayed him, which broke him. Before Peter preached 3,000 souls into the kingdom, he denied his Savior. three times, but he wept bitterly. Before Paul brought the gospel to the Gentiles, he was blinded on a road to Damascus. And I feel today in my spirit that God has a breakthrough, but it's only on the other side of brokenness. Let brokenness become a part of us.
My God. Thank you, Lord.
Let brokenness become a part of us. The songwriter wrote many years ago, he said, have thine own way, Lord.
Come on.
Have thine own way. Thou art the potter, and I am the clay. Mold me. Make me after thy will. While I am waiting, yielded and still. I will tell you today that the potter is still able to mend the broken heart today. He is still able to help the broken vessels to use for his own purpose and for his own pleasure. The devil reminds you of your brokenness, but what you need to remind him is that whenever I'm broken, God is close. God is fixing to make a way where there seemeth to be no way. Just because I'm down right now doesn't mean that I'm forsaken. God is close. God is close. God is close. He's closer than what you imagine. I want you to raise holy hands to Jesus right now. Come on. Every woman, child, boy, girl, man, raise holy hands to God. I just want you to raise your hand. God, you're close. 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 I don't know what to do. That must mean you're close. I don't know which way to take. That means you're close.
Yes, Lord. Oh, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
You may be seated today. I will tell you in this place today that a spirit of brokenness will put down gossip. A spirit of brokenness will cause us to put agendas aside. A spirit of brokenness will let our focus be only on Jesus. A spirit of brokenness will put down petty squibblings and squallings. A spirit of brokenness will cause the young and the old to brace one another. A spirit of brokenness will cause us to establish, to make room for the new souls that will come to the church. A spirit of brokenness takes us beyond just mere tolerance and into acceptance of one another. A spirit of brokenness will cause us to welcome the unique talents and the gifts and ministries of God that grants to each one of us. A spirit of brokenness will say, move over, a visitor's coming. A spirit of brokenness will cause us to have greater altar calls, more sincere altar calls, a broken spirit, more weeping, more crying, more dancing. A spirit of brokenness is what will bring a breakthrough for this church. We need a spirit of brokenness that goes on the altar and says, Lord, I must be broken as you were. God is glorified. He's lifted up. And the Bible says he draws all men into him. Tongues interpretation will come through a spirit of brokenness and worship. But before God will send any soul that's broken, he must get a church that is broken. Before God sends those that are troubled in their mind and their spirit, he must get a church that knows what it's like to be broken. But to live through the breakthrough power of God. The only way that can happen is if we have an understanding that brokenness is not a curse from God, but brokenness is a blessing from God that God brings. That's why the word of the Lord says that we ought to rejoice not only in triumph, but we ought to rejoice in trials, because we understand that Moses cannot find out what to do unless he's isolated from people that told him what to do. God will sometimes get you to a point where you're broken so that he can put the pieces back together again. That's the power, that's the anointing, that's the deliverance that comes. comes from only being broken by the word of the Lord. Your brokenness was a miracle from God. A spirit of brokenness will give you a never again attitude. I want to say that again. A spirit of brokenness will give you a never again attitude.
Come on, come on.
Come on now. You know what I'm talking about. Never again will I confess that I can't do something. For I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Never again will I confess that I have a lack of anything, because my Bible says that my God shall supply all my needs according to His riches and glory by Jesus Christ. Never again will I confess fear to run my life, for God hath not given me the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Never again will I confess a weakness, for the Lord is the strength of my life. And even when I'm at my weakness, His strength is made perfect through my weakness. Never again will I confess fear, for God has not given me the spirit of fear. You need to get a never again attitude in your spirit today. Never again will I confess Satan as dominating and controlling my life. For the Bible says that greater is He that is in me than he that is within the world. Never again will I confess that I'm defeated. For God always causes me to triumph in Christ Jesus. Never again will I confess that I lack wisdom. Because for Christ Jesus has made unto me wisdom from God alone. Never again will I confess sickness to rule my life. For by His stripes I am healed. And Jesus took my infirmities and bore my sickness. Never again will I confess worries and frustration, for I am casting all my cares upon Him, for He careth for me. Never again will I confess bondage, for where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Never again will I confess condemnation, for there is no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. Someone needs to get a never again attitude that can only be found in brokenness.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
I want to speak to you today. I'm almost done. I'm almost done. Satan has tried to convince you that your life is over. And I'm telling you right now, your life is getting started. Because the breakthrough only comes after the brokenness. Jesus can't rise up 3 days later if He doesn't allow for His body to be broken right now today. And I got news for someone here today. Someone's going to have a resurrection in their life. Satan meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. And your ladder will be greater than your former. Your blessing is coming down the dusty road, and it's only going to become a part of your life. You can only have a breakthrough on the other side of brokenness.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
There was a breakthrough that started with brokenness. I've been real. I'm just going to get a little bit more real today. Someone has suffered in their life. You've been betrayed. You've been abused. You've been mistreated. You went through a horrible pit, and you went through a tough time. I want to encourage you today. Don't you ever put a period on the end of something that God just put a comma. Your story's not over. The book is still being written. And your latter is going to be greater than your former.
Satan may be laughing now, but I promise you, I've read the back of the book, and I'm telling you, you win. You're going to be victorious. God is going to supply all your needs. God's working. He only allowed for Satan to touch you because he wants to bless you, but you never get blessed until you get broken. That's why when I come to church, I just want to praise God. Listen, I don't want none of you to know that I might be going through a trouble, because let me tell you, I don't want to give more faith to my pit than what I do my praise. That's why whether it rains or snows or sunshine, cold nor hot, my praise is not limited to how I feel, but it's limited to who He is and what He can do. I know that what God can do on the outside of a broken pit, God can establish a breakthrough, not only for my life, but for your life. Stay on the potter's wheel, and God will bless you.
Oh, yes, oh, yes. My Lord, my Lord.
Music, get up here. Everyone stand real quick. I'm skipping a couple pages here.
God, have your way, God. Have your way, God.
In order to experience a great harvest, you've got to allow for your foundation to be broken up. Brokenness provides many of the needed elements needed for a great breakthrough. You can go out there and plant a tree. You can go out there and just put a tree on the soil. It won't work. You got to learn to dig up a little bit. There's a certain temperature that tree needs to live, especially in Ohio. Can I get a witness? There's a certain foundation that tree needs, to live. God will allow for your life to be broken before He plants you. Oh, praise God. In brokenness, we find the pliability of the heart. In brokenness, we find what we could become. Not what we presently are, but what we could become if we stay in the ground that God has planted us in. No crop can grow in hard, untilled ground. Can I get a witness? There's nothing that can grow if you don't get broken. That's why God uses this saying. He said, with a broken and contrite spirit, I can't refuse you. Why? Because brokenness allows for something to dig inside of you. But the power of being broken is this, is that you only live in that environment for only a season. Brother Mark, a tree don't always stay in the ground. Oh, praise God. Can you imagine being the seed in the ground? Man, I wonder when I'm going to get out of those dark places. I like to get up. I like to get out. You only plant it for a season. Here's the thing. You need to stay planted. Brokenness is giving you what you need to grow. Brokenness is found when we sufficiently sow tears in the ground. Something breaks up your status quo. Someone had a plan and a dream and God broke it up. Someone thought they had the future planned out, but God said, wait a minute, I don't like your plans, I got better plans. Someone said themselves they got out of high school and you was going to do this and you was going to do that and you was going to change the world this way or that way, and God said, no, you're going to be a world changer, but not the way you thought. I'm going to plant you in another place. This is a perfect area for brokenness. In brokenness, we find sufficient tears to our life to water and to sow seeds. In brokenness, we find the crop beginning to show signs of life again. In brokenness, God will bring a breakthrough to our life. Broken today, breakthrough tomorrow. Here's my question for you today. Will you stay broken long enough for God to put you back together again? And just like Abraham, Jacob, Joseph, Job, Moses, Joshua, Samson, David, Daniel, Hosea, Peter, and Paul. God will give you a breakthrough if you'll stay broken before the Lord. In closing today, God has someone in a place in their life where they're broken. You're feeling empty inside. Let me tell you, God wants to fill every broken piece in your life. Don't try to put it back together yourself. You need to be just like they was in the valley of dry bones. When it's your time, God's going to call you. Stay planted where God has put you. Stay planted. God is breaking you for a purpose. It's bigger than you. It's bigger than you. It is bigger than you. God's only allowed for it to happen because He's got a blessing on the other side of brokenness. Could you begin to raise holy hands? They're playing softly. Come on, come on. I don't know what is going on in your life right now, but I'm telling you, I feel this so strong in my spirit. This brokenness is fixing to lead to a breakthrough. Your strength is drawing closer. Your help is drawing close to you right now. Draw nigh to me and I'll draw nigh to you. You don't understand how close you are. You're close. You're close. You're close. God's with you in this storm. The waters are troubling the boat, but God's with you. God's with you. Come on, church. Come on. Come on, all across this sanctuary, from the very front to the very back. I want us to begin to plead the blood of Jesus Christ, to cry out to God. Let a spirit of brokenness begin to take place in your life right now. Take off a mask. Take off that mask for a quick second. Just broken in the presence of God. Broken on the altar of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, church. Come on, family. From the pulpit to the back. Come on, let's all pray. Let's all pray right now. Come on, pray. Pray, God. I don't know why you've allowed it. I don't know why I feel this way, Lord. I don't know why I've gone through trial after trial after trial, God. But Lord, I got to believe. I got to believe that you've got a breakthrough on the other side of this brokenness. I got to believe, God, that you're in control. God, I got to believe that you're putting me back together again, Lord. I got to believe. I got to stay on that potter's wheel. I got to say, God, you've given me dreams and visions, God. I know I didn't dream that myself. It was from you, Lord. I got to stay on the wheel. I got to stay on the wheel. My potter's putting the broken pieces back together again. My potter's working it out. My potter's working it out for my good. My potter's working it out for my good. Perhaps in this place, if you want to turn your hands inside out, Lord, say, I'm ready, I'm ready. I'm ready, Jesus. I surrender. I surrender, oh God. I surrender. I surrender, oh God. God, I'm broken. God, Lord, I'm broken in all the right places. I'm broken, but I'm broken in all the right places, God. Hallelujah. Come on. Come on. God's speaking to someone. You need to move out of your seat. You need to move out of your seat. Let those tears begin to flow at the altar. Come on. Move out of your seat. If God's speaking to you, I want you to come down the front. I want you to raise holy hands to Jesus. Jesus is the only one that can put everything back together again. But He's all that you need. He's all that you need. It is all in Him. Satan is not in control. God is in control. Before Satan had permission to do it to you, he had to go to your God and ask permission. Let me tell you, God would have not have given him permission to kill you, but He's given you permission to establish you. This brokenness will lead to your breakthrough, but keep holding on to the unchanging hand of a loving God. That's it, that's it, that's it, that's it. Surrender, surrender, surrender. Come on, church, come on, everyone pray, everyone pray. Those that are at the front, lift up holy hands to Jesus.
Move it, something changed.
That's it, that's it.
See His glory.
God's
feels
close.
Like heaven on earth.
God's
something
close.
Moved.
God's close.
Something changed.
He's closer than the mention
see
of His name.
See His glory.
Oh, yeah.
Feels like heaven on earth.
Oh.
Something's moving.
Something moved.
Something
That's it. I want you to go link up with somebody. For those of you that are in the front, for those of you that are still in your seats, link up with somebody. Put your arm around somebody. Link up with an intercessory prayer warrior right now. Link yourself up. You don't have someone, go and find somebody. That's it. Come on, I want you to pray right now. Pray right now like the room is on fire. Pray right now with passion, with prayer, with zeal. This brokenness will lead to your next breakthrough. This hard time is going to lead to your high time. Yes, sir. It would scare you if you realize how close you were, sir. It would scare you if you realize how close you were, sir. That's it. Pray in the tongues. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Except a corn of wheat fall into the ground and die, it abideth alone. I don't know about you, but I want to die in the Lord. Back to the Lord. Just linger here for a minute. God's doing something.
The Lord spoke to me when we first started pastoring. Actually, it was before I ever preached my first service. He told me, he said, I'll grow the church, but the day you start taking glory for it, I'll stop. I'll stop. And every time I get a chance, I always just will say, this is God's church. This is God's people. I didn't do none of this. God did all of it. He brought a lot of people together to do His will. But we have grown because God did it. None of ourselves. None of ourselves. It is all in Him. I say that because I say this. I believe that there are so many churches that God wants to bless, but He can't bless. Because man always gets in the way. You don't hear, I've never heard a preacher say that before, but I just did. Preachers, they say, well, I don't want to grow too fast, so I won't be able to control it. There's your problem. You weren't meant to control it. It was meant for God to control it. Our church is only as good as our spirit of humility and our spirit of humbleness on this. We did nothing. God did everything. And if we will give God the glory, He will give us the results. In your home, if you'll give God the glory, God will give you the results. If you will say, Lord, I did nothing, but God, You made a way where there seemed to be no way, Lord. God, it was all in You, Jesus. My miracle was all about You. Lord, I just got connected to You. It's You. It's You. It's You. It's You. And you find it in brokenness. You find it in being broken. That's why don't curse your brokenness. God can do more with less. He can do more with less. One more time, all across the church. This is our last time. We've got to close this out with prayer. We've got to close this out with prayer. Jesus, it's You. It's You. It's You. Only You, God. It's You. You're the reason I live, I move, I have my being, God. You're everything, God. You're everything to me. God, just use these feeble hands, God. Use this back, God. Use my hands and my feet. Use this mouth, God. Let me just be the clay. God, You're the potter. It's You. It's You. It's You. It's You, God. God, I reverence You, God. When I was broken, God, You were putting me back together again. But this time I'm stronger than what I was before. God, because You never restore something to the same place. You always restore it better. You always restore it better, God. God, I'm going to stay on the potter's wheel. I'm going to trust You for my breakthrough. And I'm going to believe that You're nigh to me. You're closer to me, God. I'm going to believe that You're in control. And God, my eyes are on the hill for which cometh my help. I'm trusting that my answer's close. My answer's on the way. And I have faith in my God that my God will not let me down. My brokenness is for a season, but my breakthrough is for my life. And I trust You. I believe in You. You are my God, and I am Your child. And Lord, I reverence You with my worship. I reverence You with my praise. I reverence You with my life. In the name of Jesus, let us stay on the wheel. In Jesus, if you're praying, pray as long as you like today. Lord bless you. Lord bless you. Lord bless you.